had some years to climb. And I've had some weary days. They can't see. of all in your presence to bring your word as you've given it, that your people may receive it, hear it, and believe it. And we put all of our praise to heaven where you are to bless you and your host that's all about you and all that fill this room with your anointing, with your esteem. To you, Father, we give all praise and honor. To your beloved son, Yahushua HaMashiach, we say to you, Todah Rabba. All praises to you.
All praises to
God. And we say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on, let's shout hallelujah. So I got news for you today. I'm your mailman.
Hallelujah.
Need my mail.
And I got a message for you from heaven.
Thank you.
He did not send it over the wire, nor did he send it by snail mail. But he just put it in my heart to tell you what's in his heart.
Thank you.
The Father told me to tell you this, because I don't know how to tell you what I got to tell you, but he's going to tell me what to say. But as you've been going through this life, at some point, you wondered, is it worth it to suffer like this? Is it worth it to shed bitter tears? Most people can't even explain why they cry, why they feel so distant. But yet, we hold on. We don't understand all of the magnitude of the kingdom. We can't see beyond our nose concerning what he has prepared. But we keep on holding on. Sometimes we feel like we don't have a friend. Surely we can cry on when we need to cry. Sometimes we don't have anything to alleviate the pain that courses through our bodies. No doctor, no nurse, no medicinal field whatsoever can help us, but we keep on holding on. What is it that he has that is so tremendous to give us the incentive to go another day, let alone another year? What keeps giving us hope that transform our thoughts from negative to positive? What is it that makes it worth it? Well, that's what I want to talk to you about today.
Hallelujah.
I took all of that time just to introduce you to the message. And the message is, just take a look at what I have for you.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
I got something for you. I made some serious promises to you.
Yes, hallelujah.
And I know sometimes it looked like it's just not coming to pass, but I'm here to tell you it's on the way.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
I'm here to tell you, get ready.
Hey! Hallelujah!
Don't let him find you unworthy.
Yes. Hallelujah.
To receive what he has.
Yes.
Because I got some bad news for some people.
Hallelujah.
Because it's not for everybody.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
It's only for those that he chooses.
He chooses. Thank you. Hallelujah.
We can't tell him how to choose.
That's right.
who to choose,
who to choose,
when to choose, and where to choose it from.
Hallelujah.
We are in a house that is called by his name.
Yeah.
But I remember he told us that he's got sheep that are not in this fold.
Right.
Even those he must bring.
That's right.
Be careful who you're talking about.
That's right. Hallelujah.
Come on. So the very one you're talking about might beat you in.
Hallelujah.
So you need to start being concerned about your own salvation.
Yes.
Work that out.
Yeah.
Yes.
Then you're doing something that's beneficial to you.
That's right. Hallelujah.
But I heard him tell Kiefer, once you're converted,
go back.
Then you can go back and strengthen your brothers.
Hallelujah.
But get yourself right first.
Yes.
Check yourself out.
Go with me, if you will, to Matthew 19.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
Just remember now, I'm a long-winded preacher.
It's all right. It's all right.
Extra long-winded teacher.
That's okay.
That's all right, too.
I got more time than money. I got a witness. And as long as he's giving me time,
yeah,
I'm thankful. And then I can do the work.
Yeah.
And I love the job.
Yeah.
Matthew 19, looking at verse 16 and 17, it says these words.
Yeah.
It says, and see, one came and said to him, good teacher, good teacher, what good shall I do? You know, proud man, that to have eternal, everlasting life. What should I do?
Yeah.
I got plenty of money, plenty of stuff. What should I do? I got the world at my feet. What should I do? I can buy a little bit from you if I have to. What can I do? Messiah just clearly told him. He
said, yeah.
What did he tell that boy? And he looked at me and said, why do you call me good? He turned and asked him a question. How do you know how good I am if you don't even hang with me? You trying to play a trick.
Yeah.
Calling me good, master, and you don't even know me.
Yeah.
But let me explain something to you. No one is good except one. But if you wish to enter into life, keep the commandments. You may be seated. Now that sounds very simplistic, doesn't it? If you want to enter life, and we're not talking about ordinary life, we're talking about eternal life. If you want to enter in eternal life, keep the commandments. So I told you, yeah, y'all got something for you. Look what I got for you. Look what he told that young man. He said, you got plenty of money, but I got everlasting life.
Which one you want to choose?
And if you want it, you got to keep my commandments. Now we got preachers and teachers going around, prophesying.
Yeah.
You don't have to keep the commandments anymore.
Yes.
They've been done away with now. We're in the New Testament.
Yes.
As if the testament that the Father gave cannot transcend time.